Hi, good evening, Touhid. How are you?
Good evening, Anna. I'm good.
I'm doing fine. Welcome to Ivy's channel, where we are talking to all our alumni who have been placed and kind of going to go through the process that was there, your journey in finding the dream job and in the way helping others to pave their path to their dream jobs as well. So tell me, Touhid, give me a little bit of your background, like what educational background you have.
So ma'am, after my 10th standard, I did a diploma in mechanical engineering. By that time, I didn't knew what was my career. So I just went in with something related to maths. I asked my parents for, and they said that engineering was the right one then. But after my diploma, I realized I have been getting away from maths. Last year was totally on mechanical. So my passion basically from childhood was doing something in mathematics. So then I transitioned my career to mathematics and got very basic. I did my graduation in mathematics after then. Then I did my post-graduation. Yesterday I got my degree certificate of post-graduation also and completed my master's in mathematics. So this is about my educational background.
All right. And how did you link your education to data analytics or data science? Like what made you trigger that, okay, I love mathematics, probably this is a good career choice?
Yes, ma'am. Till the last semester or the second last semester, I didn't actually knew about data analytics. I was not connected to it. But then we had a presentation on a SIR model, which is a mathematical model where we study about the population and about the various diseases. It was based on the COVID model. So COVID data was used. So I got an opportunity to present that model. And while presenting, I prepared, there was a Python code in it and where we trained and tested the model. So I got to know more about data and how can data solve real life world problems. And it was very nicely explained there. How can we, by using lockdown and social distancing, how it can affect and it can give results that was proved by mathematics and with the help of data. So combining mathematics with data is what I found out in this model. And then I tried searched more about this data, and then I found out about data analytics and how I can link both. Also, I found that being a sports enthusiast, I used to analyze some games whatever. So I felt like there is some connection there. So I felt like more connected to this data analytics, and then I started there.
Wonderful. So you graduated, you finished your post-graduation 2021, correct?
Yes.
And then you ended up with your dream job in Google in
2022? 2020.
Okay. Can you talk about a little bit of, what do you think are the main elements that a person, a fresher, should concentrate on in order to transition? Because I'm sure in this 1 year, you have rigorously gone through learning various tools. So which tools you think, by giving, multiple interviews you have given, so in different organizations, what tools were emphasized on and how do you prepare for it?
When I transitioned into mathematics, I didn't know a path where to get my career done. And through this data analytics, I found a path. But finding that path, I was very fresh. And at that time, 2021, 2020, so there was, it was still new for most of us. In my circle, friend circle, or in my surrounding area, no one was related to it. So first of all, I had to find contacts and then move forward. So then I found out about Ivy and joined to Ivy. I found that connection to this field. And then I started learning new tools with Ivy. So I would for data analytics related, the basics should be very cleared in the beginning only, and that was only possible because of Ivy. You and Pratik sir were best, I can say, in teaching Excel and SQL. So these two tools are very important. I still get training in my Google, still get trained on these tools also in my job.
Mm-hmm.
So these two tools are very important going forward in data analytics firm. And finding the right path very early is also important. Like I found out before my 6 to 8 months before completing my post graduation, I found out this. And then I started from IV at that time. So after my post graduation, after two, 3 months, I had done all my courses through IV. So mm-hmm. I completed in that. So I didn't waste much of time after my post graduation. So finding the right path beforehand also helps.
Absolutely. All right, tell me, you said you did your diploma after class 10th and then you did your graduation and post-graduation. Did in any way affect your, you know, the calls, interview calls? Because that's a very common question that is asked by to me also, that if I come from a diploma background, does it affect my chances of interview? What was your take on it? Like, what's your take on it?
No, actually, it was the other way around. They were very much impressed, listening to that transition and my taking the decision of this call, because after diploma, I had to waste 1 year because I didn't get admission to the second year BSc. I got mm-hmm. to first year BSc. So that wasted like 1 year of mine. So they were very, I took that call. I said, I want to follow the mathematics. So I took that call and the interviewers also listening to that story were pretty much impressed rather than saying you come from diploma or non-coding background. So pretty much impressed with that. It was
I think
totally
because rather. It shows your passion towards what you want to learn.
Yes,
you to be able to sacrifice 1 year is just pure passion. That it's all passion that you have. And how much of mathematics are you still going to, you know, going forward, you've done Python and machine learning. So how much of mathematics do you think was applicable to it?
Yes, ma'am. Mathematics, starting from Excel also, we can say finding out the right formula to implement that. There also we can use mathematics, not only in Python and all.
Mm-hmm.
In Python and machine learning, so there the basics of linear algebra, like vectors and matrices, multiplication, addition. These concepts are, if you are a good control on it, you can optimize some models, which is very important in business firms, like doing fast and accurate, but optimizing the models is also very important part, which is done using these basic tools. Also, advanced calculus is used, which is very helpful going in machine learning models.
Okay. And before Google, which other company did you appear for interview?
So I was parallelly interviewing with math company. It was like the dates were overlapping at times. So the math company also I have interviewed and I also got their offer letter from them also. So that was also a success from my side.
And that's another very good company, boutique company in analytics world.
So actually, to be honest with you, after my 3 months of IV, I was only hoping that I would get to math company. I used to see math company and I had completed Python that time. So I was just hoping when will I complete my Python module and when will I go for an interview with math company. So it was like math. The word is coming along and then it's all joining up. And then yeah. I got to know about math company. I had seen a session with Prateek sir and the CEO of math company. So
yes,
there, so that also motivated me, like they had in-house training in there. And it was all going very good. Google came up and then.
All right. So Touhid, if you could help the audience to understand that how they should be preparing for a company like the math company.
Yeah, ma'am. For math company, like I wanted, I was very serious about it to be very sure. And then they, their first round was online assessment, technical round. So for that, I had prepared using the help of Farooq sir helped me out a bit. Like I was very worried that I don't come from a coding background. So how will I go for a Python basics and all those things? So Farooq sir helped me a lot in that time, like he told 2-3 websites where I can practice queries, some basics. And also I've also asked Prateek sir regarding help in that because after SQL, it was like 6-8 months. So I had just lost touch. So sir also advised me to do some case studies, which will, you know, get me the revision done of SQL. And that's how I prepared for that.
All right. So one last question, Touhid. Like a lot of people who are freshers typically come and say, you know, only working professionals are being hired, freshers are not being hired. So what do you think freshers should be doing, except for like writing one line of in their resume that we have done a certification of data science or data analytics? What do you think are the key things that someone would pick your resume and give you a call for an interview?
Actually, I was one of them saying those. The only freshers experience gets are getting jobs. So building resumes and strong resumes only comes up with doing projects and internships that are very important being a fresher. Also, a good academic background not always is required, but it's good to have it. And but mostly it's all about projects and internships, how you present them and how strongly you represent. Like in my interviews with Map Company and with Google, I was asked mostly about projects. So, and how did I deliver them and how did I spoke about it? It was very approachable. Like, how do you approach to that project?
Absolutely. I think in today's time, the only way to engage someone's hand-on understanding of the tool is through the projects. The more projects, the better it is. Even if someone's profile is not great in terms of percentage of marks or what college you belong to or gaps, if you have good, ample amount of you know, projects that are in your resume, the whole ballgame of who is dictating in the interview changes.
Yes, ma'am.
So good. I was just wanting to confirm and make sure that all of us, you know, believe in that, that projects is what helps us to get these job interviews.
Yes.
Perfect. All right, Touhid, thank you so much for your time. It is, you know, we are very proud to have you as an alumni of Ivy. And definitely, whenever you get a chance, let us know and, you know, keep talking to us. Keep, you know, spreading your knowledge to others.
Yes. Thank you so much, ma'am, for having me and giving this opportunity to experience all.
All right. Thank you. Thank you so much, Touhid. All the best. Thank you. Bye-bye.